Yeah, I'm from odumase-krobo. That's the eastern part of Ghana. Yeah, where we are now. Odumase-krobo, we are the Krobos. And we have part here and part also in Somanya. See, but I can say that our main work is farming. And the bead making is like something like a hobby. But for me, I take it as my main business. So I do a lot of things about glass. I teach bead making. I give lectures on African beads and the uses of bead in our culture. And you see, we have a whole lot of unique things that we do here. And the festivals also as well. So, but one of the most biggest uses of bead, that is the depot. We the Krobo, if you have a baby boy, and after 7 days, circumcision takes place. Then after that, all the people in the family will present a lot of gifts to the boy mother. And that thing became a jealousy to those who have the female, you know, babies. Then they presented this issue to Nana Kluweki. She led us from wherever we came from to Krobo Mountain. Then she also introduced Depot for the girls. Then it's like, you know, the vocational training. Because as a woman or as a girl, by all means you grow up and you enter into marriage. So they'll teach you a whole lot of things. How to take care of yourself, your children, your uncles, your father-in-law, your mother-in-law, and entire family. And even how to take proper care of your husband. That's why you see that you know, if you marry to a Krobo woman, even you feel more comfortable the way how she will handle you, and you see the kind of respect that she will give it to you is unique. So they will teach you all those kind of things during the, you know, during the depot. They will go to Riverside, they will show you how to wash your panties, and you see in the olden days they use loin cloth because they don't have panties, you wear beads. And they wrap themselves with the loin cloth. So if you have your menses and things, they will teach you how to treat all those kind of things, hygiene. But they wear a lot of beads. Some people wear about 25 kilos of bead. Then everybody have to come and dance, show their skills, a whole lot of things. And Monday, they will dress them up. After you pass through all this thing, they will bring all, the family will bring all their very expensive clothes, beads, and things like that. They will dress them, they will line them up, drumming and dancing, and you will dance, and they will present a whole lot of things to you. Most of the gifts are beads, because those things, if you take good care of it, it's forever. Your great-grandchildren also will come and use it. That's why we have the antique beads, because they pass on from generation to generation. Even there are some beads that are over 30 years before Jesus Christ was born. And even that time, we don't have glass beads, but they have stone, they have seed, they have wood, bones. Anything that they can pierce holes through it, they classify it as bead. And the word bead is from the Latin word bene. Bene means to pray. So we count bead, we use bead to count our prayers. That's why the Roman Catholic used rosary when there was no glass. They use a fermented rose flower, then they make them like a ball, they dry them, they put it on the string, then they use it to count their prayers. And the same way, the Islamic people also use tasbih to count their prayers, then after that they put it on their wrist or their neck, then it became as a jewelry. So bead has a very long history. My real name is Nomoda Djaba, known as Cedi. Cedi is my popular name. You know, I was born not quite long that they have changed our money from Point to Cedi. Then my grandmother was saying that before you carry my first grandchild, you have to bring a new Cedi. Then everybody calls me Cedi up to date. Good. And I have started bead making when I was 7. And that time was in class 2. We have 2 sessions, go to school morning and back in the afternoon. In the afternoon, my grandmother sent me to go and call my parents to come and have their lunch. When they left there, I pick up one of the empty mold, design something very quickly, and put it on top of theirs. When they came back, they were very annoyed because they don't want the children to go close to the fire inside. But when the bead came out, it looks nice. And they asked me, can you repeat the same thing? And I said, I don't know. Then they gave me another mold to try my hands on it. I did the second one. It looks close to the first one. When they send it to the market, all the customers want to buy that particular bead. Then I have to teach my brothers, sisters, those who were already in it, and I'm in it up to date. So through bead making, I was able to travel almost all over the world. In bead making, we have 5 types of beads. And the first one, we call it recycled antique bead. That is the old broken one, like this. You can see some of the old patterns. You see? We rearrange it nicely in the mold and fire it. And that is the finished product. You can see some of the old patterns. And the second one also, we call it recycled transparent bead. And that one, we use broken bottles or empty bottles like this. It can be beer bottle, Heineken's, make of magnesia, Coca-Cola, Fanta, etc. Any kind of bottle or glass at all is good for us. We wash it nicely. After that, we break it into smaller pieces. Then we get the chunks like this. Then you can mix 3, 4, 5 colors. But before you do that, you have to study the way how each glass works. Some are compatible to each other, some are not. If you mix the ones that are not compatible, after nailing, you lose everything. So it is very, very important to check the compatibility of each glass before you mix them. So now, I'll use my hand to fill the mold. Then this one also is ready for firing. But because of the particles, this one takes 30 to 45 minutes. And it's about 800 to 1000 degrees Celsius. When it melts, we bring it out. Then we use these 2 pins. We use these 2 pins. We use our left hand to press it this way while it's still hot. Use the right one to pierce the hole at the center of it. Dress the bottom nicely. Turn it over and do the same thing to become round like this. After that, we leave it on the floor for exactly 1 hour for annealing. That is the cooling process. But when the weather is very hot, it takes more than that. We remove it nicely. We have a special stone for polishing. But I would like to finish this play before we go there. Then, that is the finished product. We have beer bottle and Coca-Cola bottle. Beer for the green, Coca-Cola for the clear. And the third one also, we call it recycled glass powder bead or powdered glass bead. And that one also, we use the same bottles, but we prefer to use the clear one so that you can mix it with any color. Then we point it with metal, mortar, and a pestle. We use nose covers, goggles and gloves. Then we point it this way. You see? You see the way how we point it? Then after pounding the glass, we sieve it with a mesh. Then we get a fine powder like this. You know, in the olden days, our great-grandparents, they break it and grind it. This one can take them more than 3 to 4 days. But now, we decided to use this. Within a short time, we can get more. And these are some of the samples of the pigment that we use for coloring. So if you want to make a yellow bead, we just add a little bit, we stir it and we get it. If red or black also, the same thing. After that, we design it inside the mold. It can be striped, horizontal, circle, dotted, then that's the result. It looks like clay, but it's glass. That's the recycled glass powder bead. Decided to use broken car parts. And that one generates more heat and it lasts for a longer period. So when it melts, we use a spatula to bring it out. Work on it very quickly, it's like a barbecue tong. Then work on it very quickly and leave it on the floor for an hour. But when the weather is very hot, it takes more than that. We remove it because of the kaolin. You cannot see the real color of it. The moment that I pour water on it, then the color will pump up. So you see now, it's not yet polished, but you can see the colors. The place where we feed the kiln with firewood. And you know, in the olden days, our great-grandparents used bellu, like a big pump, the blacksmith used. So one person have to stand here to be blowing, you know, air all the time. But now, before we build the kiln, we studied the way how the natural air blew. So we are now using natural air, so we don't use bellu anymore. So normally we get the air from the bottom to the top. And if you want to pour it also, you make it like a broomstick, it will never generate the temperature that you want, but you make it a crisscross so that the air can go into it without fanning it or any value.
Right.
So in the night, it glows. So you don't need electricity. In the olden days, there were a whole lot of wars everywhere, every country, every community, every corner. So we were led by the a queen or fetish priest, or I can say a leader called Nana Kluweki. Nana Kluweki. Yes. And she also introduced Dipo for a Krobo women. According to the history, we migrated from Israel through, you know, Egypt, all the way to Nigeria, through Togo, then all the way to Ghana before Krobo Mountain. Even when they reached the Volta Lake, no bridge, nothing else, and she was able to, you know, to let them cross without any bridge. And there is a leaf, I forgot the name of the, I think totem or something like that, an English name, When they get to the river bank, then that leaf spread on the surface of the river, and they were able to walk on the surface of the river without sinking. Culture is very, very important. If you know your root, it's good for you. See, the book that I told you about it, you see, there is a bead in called chevron. And this kind of bead, you see, I've learned part in the States, and I did some, and I put it, we documented it, or we featured it in the book. When they sent the book to Europe and America, then a lot of people were saying, oh yeah, this bead cannot be produced in Ghana. And they were talking about it, a whole lot of things. And I did one, I did six pieces with my initials on it, like Cedi. And I sent it to them, no talking up to now. We know it, we pass on through our children, because we also learn from our grandparents and grandfathers. And we also, we teach our people like that. But now, I'm trying to, you know, to put a whole lot of things on paper so that even when we are no more, people also can take it and read it. The olden days, you see, your parents or your grandfathers who in the evening they will gather the whole family and tell them stories. Stories that you learn out of it. You see, things that even if you take or if you listen to it very well, you learn a whole lot of things and it can guide you throughout your life. But nowadays, those things are no more. Even in our schools here, now difficult before you see children learning about history. So how can we grow? That's why everything is, you know, a whole lot of things. It will get a time that unless we go to maybe advanced countries and pay money for it before we learn our own history. So now we are going to number four. And the fourth one, we call it glazed bead or painted bead. And that one can be translucent or opaque. We make the bead first. After that, we wash it nicely, no design. Then we mix a powdered glass with water. Glass powder mixed with water and add a little bit of pigments in it. Use a wooden pin to stir it nicely and use the same pin to design it outside the bead. And if you want to repeat the same design, then we put it on the pot like this. I have a, yeah. Then you put the same design on it, like a kebab. After designing it, then we leave it in the sun for 10 to 15 minutes to dry. You can leave it under the shade, but it takes longer time. Then we put it back into the mold and refire it. So with this, you can feel the design outside, but it will never come off because we use the same glass and fire it twice. And the last one, special for chiefs and the queen mothers, for king and queens. And the name of that bead is called bodom bead. B-O-D-O-M simply means backing, like the way our dogs bark. If you wear a bead or a necklace, you have to put big one at the center of it. And that one will attract people to see the type of bead that you wear. In our culture, The type of bead that you wear will show how important or how wealthy you are in a society. And I would like to design one of the simple ones for you to see. And for you to see what I'm coming to do now, I will design it in the clear glass so that you can see from A to Z. We use cassava leaf stock. We place it at the center of the mold before designing. And you know, in the olden days, our great-grandparents, they used their fingers like this. And one mold can take them more than 4 good hours. But now, we decided to use empty powdered can or aluminum sheet. We cut it with scissors, then we call it scoop or funnel. Less than 5 or 6 minutes, I can design something for you to see. So after tipping the first glass powder, I want all my lines to be straight, to become very neat. Then I have to use my wooden pin to dress all the edges before adding new color to it. So after tipping the first glass powder, I want all my lines to be straight, to become very neat. Then I have to use my wooden pin to dress all the edges before adding new color to it. And I use different color. So I have to make a circle between the valley. So I'll make a dot in it. And after firing, it will look like an eye. I have to close the circle now. To bead maker, you need a stable hand.
It's like surgery.
Yes. So now, I have finished with the bottom part. What I did at the bottom, I have to do the same thing at the top. So this one is ready, then I have to fill it with the beige. That is the main color.
Wow,
then I have to tap it down. Then this one also is ready for firing, and the powdered one takes 20 to 35 minutes, and it's about 600 to 800 degrees Celsius, whereas the transparent one takes 30 to 45, and that one 800 to 1000 degrees Celsius. Before you make a bead, the first thing you have to do is to build a firewood kiln. You see that one over there? We'll go there. We use ant hill clay. That is the termite mound. I think you have seen a lot. You know, the termites, they go deep into the ground, bring a good soil. There is a special saliva, that is the enzyme from the termite, that makes the clay very sticky to stand for very high temperature without breaking. After that, we use the same clay, but we pound the clay like the way I will pound fufu. Then we roll it on the table nicely. It's like a mashed potato. Then we roll it on the table nicely. Then we cut it into slices. We use this wooden bar to make it round. We have different kind of shapes. We have smaller size, tilapia fish, star, crows. Before we have a very tiny one. You know, in Ghana or in Africa, our women wear beads on their waist. These are some of the type of beads that make it for them. So you see the mold, tiny, tiny mold. Then after making the clay round, we use the carved stick to stamp it. The number of holes that we feel we can work on it within a short time. After that, we leave it in a room temperature for 3 to 4 days. We bring it out to the sun for the same period. Then we fire it with a very high temperature to become very strong. Then we coat it with kaolin mixed with water to prevent sticking. That is ayilo. Without this, or without the kaolin, when it melts, the glass will stick in it. Then you can't use it anymore. So kaolin is very, very important for bead making. This one, they make it direct, straight to the clay mold.
Yeah.
But this one, you cannot see. That's why, for demonstration, then we make it in a clear glass,
right,
so that you can see from A to Z.
Right.
So now we go to the polishing side, and see the way how we clean the beads. The polishing process takes 10 to 15 minutes. And we use sand and water to make it to and fro. A sand that is not too coarse and not too smooth. So the one in between. The same thing that the seed does. You see that there's small, small stone inside? They keep on rolling. Before they get to an ocean or to get to the seashore, then you see that it becomes smooth and clean. So the same thing that we do here. And the polishing process takes 10 to 15 minutes. And we use sand and water and make it to and fro. And this one is not yet ready, but I would like to pour a little bit of water on it for you to see. It's not yet ready, but you can see the colors now. Then we wash it with clean water. We put it on the table over there for stringing. Then it's ready for marketing. The color will never come out because all these colors are from inside to outside. And even these are the colors from the original bottles.
Yeah.
And the powdered one, we use ceramic pigment. A pigment that can stand for about 1,000 degrees Celsius without losing its original color. So this one, it will never fade. Yes. Then we go to the stringing side. You see the way how we put them together. In the olden days, they used no more thread like this. But this one, if you use it for a bracelet, if you tie it, it's difficult to remove it, difficult to wear. So you wear it till you carry it. But now, we decided to use elastic. Our elastic cord, and you see it's stretchy, so you can easy to wear, easy to remove it. So all this one, put it on elastic, you see this one now, then it's easy to wear, easy to remove. When I was a student, my aim is to become a medical doctor or an accountant, or to be a bank manager. So I was doing both, business subject and the science. And that subject also helped me a lot in the bead making, because bead making is a completely science subject. The compatibility of each glass and the color mixing, that we have the primary and the secondary colors, and even how to control the temperature also as well. So it helps me a lot. And the business part also helped me how to market yourself. You see, after school, and then, you know, that time it's difficult to get a job or even to further more, unless you have a lot of money before you can do that. Then in 1993, I was still doing the bead, but in 1997, they were having a show in a course and a show in New York City. And I work with 8 artisans Ghana. They have the handicraft and things like that. And I had a call and they said, Cedi, if you can pay your ticket, 8 artisans in the state, they can pay for your accommodation, your per diem, but for the ticket, you have to do it yourself. And the training also, they will take care of it. And I said, okay, if something like that, I'll try to, to join them. And only 4 of us were selected in Ghana here. 1 from Krobos, that's part of Accra. By then, I've joined them. Ashanti region, Nofi region, and the executive director, also part of us. And that time, only Ghana Airways is there, the popular airline that we have in Ghana. So you book today, you get to the airport, they say, oh, Ghana Airways is coming from, from Lagos or Abidjan. You'll be there for 2-3 days. It will never come, go and come tomorrow. Before you realize, then I left them. So then we started our training in New York. Then from New York, then we went to Farmington, that's Connecticut. We did everything over there and back to New York. So before the 3 of them arrived in the state, then I was so popular among them. Then I have to introduce them to, to the members, and they were taking a lot of photographs. We were there and I had another invitation in Boston. Then I said, look, I have to come back to Ghana. Then before I get to Ghana, another invitation in Switzerland. So I came back, prepared, back to US again, from US to Switzerland. I was in Switzerland, another invitation in Germany. Then anywhere I go, then I, do a lot of courses and, how to teach adults and kids. In the US, you can't just wake up from Ghana and go and start teaching or things like that. You have to train you also first. You see, there's a way how to teach kids and the way how to teach adults, Then I did that. And I was featured in a lot of magazine, books and things, and everyday invitation everywhere. Then I became popular up to date. So I'm one of the, so even in 2018, I won Living Tradition Award in US in Santa Fe. So I'm one of the mentor to market. So whenever we're having a trade show, I have to take the new artist, how to receive customers, how to talk to them, how to present your goals, the eye level, and things that you don't need to do in your stand. You don't need to be making calls while the customers are coming. You don't need to eat in your booth while customers are talking to you. You don't need to be sleeping, nodding your head, and whole lot of things. So I train people also on that. At times I go to the universities over there. I was in the University of Texas in Arlington. I did a lot of lecturing over there. Newark Museum, if you go there, you see one of our symbols there. Yeah. And I make a chief necklace. We have an African, you know, part that you see a whole lot of things. So we are trying to project Ghana, to sell Ghana. There was a time that I wrote an application with the one Center for National Culture Officer. But when the money came, I was in the state by then. Then they changed the signatories and they misused the money. And so quickly then I went back to the European Union and I told them that I have, you know, stepped back from that thing because I don't want my name to be tarnished during that thing. Because the plan is that every year, at first they gave us 50,000 Ghana, about 5 years ago, 50,000 Ghana, and every year they top it to 20,000, making 70,000. Every year they will top up so that, you know, and we make it first Ghana International Bead Festival. Ghana International Bead Festival. But they destroyed the whole thing. That's the point. Yes, because we want to make it such a way that every year people will travel all over the world to come and see, and we'll make a place where the firing will be going on every day. People will be trying their hands on it. We'll take people through the process. We'll make it like 9:30, make another batch, 11:30, another batch, 2:30. Then people will be going around to do their shopping. When it's time for 9:30, they will come to the studio, have a seat, they watch the questions and answers. Then it will let people to buy more because people want to know the material used, the process and the things. Then that's why people come here, we take them through the process. Then they appreciate the bead itself. But people, oh, just glass. But if you take them through the process, then they know that, yes, hard work and it's good. I'll use a special spectacle here so that I can see through the flame.
Science.
Yes.
So what are these?
These are glass skin or rod. So this one is about 1200 degrees.
Wow.
Very high.
Yes.
So this one, we use this one also to make marbles for playing games. So you see, at times if we do things here, then people come from advanced countries and they say, oh, I don't think if they see the bead somewhere in a show, in a showroom, then they say, this one is too shiny, it's too smooth, I don't think you can do it here, but you can make it here.
Wow.
This oxygen is almost empty, but this one is a new one because I'm trying to do a whole lot of queen chain.
Oh, I see.
So you see, keep on turning, I'll make a very small bit for you to see. The chunk, the chunky ones are, you know, it takes time to make it.
Right.
Because this one, I have to gather all the cane. So I can keep on trying to make a big marble.
I see, I see. So as it melts, it makes, it gets bigger and bigger.
And this also is stainless steel coated with kaolin. So without kaolin, you cannot make bead.
Otherwise, it would just stick.
Yes. So I'm now gathering the glass. So you see, this one, we do it in the room. So if people come, they don't know that we have something here like this.
Yeah.
And this one also takes too much of time.
Yeah.
So if I'm coming to do proper work or bead, then I come here and do it. So if people see the final product or the finished product, then they say, I don't think you can do this one here. There's an air bubble there,
mm-hmm.
So I have to make it to, you know.
To remove it.
Yeah. So I'm not shaping it. This is graphite, the same material that they use to make pencils. Yeah. And this one we set them piece by piece so that you can put it on the leather cord. And you wear only a piece. But some people also buy the whole strand. This one is done. I make flowers on it, but normally, and at times I can make it and use this one to cover the whole thing so that you see the flower inside. Then people ask, how do you manage to, you know, to do the design inside? And I can leave it on it like this, that you can easily feel. Mm-hmm. And I can make it to become very smooth also, so that you cannot feel the flowers. So I have to reheat the whole thing. I need an even temperature. And if I make a bigger chunks, I put it into electric kiln.
Oh, okay. Wow.
And this one, I put it into vermiculite.
And what does the vermiculite do?
You see, they use it in the flower garden. You see, so that the wings will not grow, but it keeps the temperature warm for some time before slowly and then goes down very slowly. So the moment that I put the glass in, then the color changes.
Yeah.
It will turn, but with the spectacle that I wear, I can easily see through.
Oh, I see.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
I'm finished with this, and I have to fire polish it to become more shiny.
So, does this mean that these ones are more expensive than the other ones that you use?
Yes. Yes. So I have to put it in the vermiculite and I have to keep on turning. Rather than that, I'll lose the shape.
Oh, really? Oh,
mm. To become hardened, that's why I keep on turning.
Wow.
I don't want to lose the shape. Become darker a little bit.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So you can see the flowers on it.
Wow.
Back to glass. And I bury it into vermiculite. Then, oxygen off, propane also off. And I have a few skins that I used to make rain with gold and things.
These are beautiful, man.
And sometimes I can melt this one and blow it to become like a balloon. Of it is forever, because most of them are made out of glass. Before, we have the stone bead also as well, and the clay and the seed bead. Yes.
So the stone beads, is it just stone that's been carved or?
Yes. Most of them are granite. You see the black and white stone? Yes, but they are not common anymore. Because it's very difficult to do it, you pierce hole through it, and it's a hard stone also as well.
Right.
Yes. Before, we have the soft one. That's the, we call it, that one, if you go to Achim Sai Chebi, you can get some bauxite bead. You see that one?
No, I've never seen
it. We have some of the old one also.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. We have old bead before we have the one that we produce now.
So the stone ones, how did they infuse the colors?
Original from the stone itself. The color is from the stone.
From the stone itself. Oh, yes. That's why it's difficult to.
Yes.
Find, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh wow. So those must be really expensive.
Wow. Yes, but mostly the glass ones are expensive.
Oh okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But some of the stone one also, the granite one, also very, very expensive.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. If they put them in water, if it is dirty, you can wash it with water. Then that's it. And you, after that, you can oil it, or you can put Vaseline on it, or baby oil. But that one is optional. And at times, you see, in Africa or here, what they do is that if they want to wear a bead, they want it very stiff. But in Europe or America, they want it loose to become flexible. But for us, even if you go to the market, you see that they tie them very tight. And if you put it in water, it also become tight. You see? And it's glass, so if you put it in, it won't do anything. That's why people cherish glass bead more than the other bead, like a clay bead. It can absorb water when it's in water for long, let's say for months or years. It will become soft.
Yeah, porous.
Which is not okay, but the glass, it can be in water for years, nothing happens to it.
Oh, okay. And she was telling me some people even bury the beads for it to look.
Yeah, that one, you see, a whole lot of, you see, at times people say after the end of the rainbow, if you dig it, then you get it. It's never true. What happened is that in the olden days, our great grandparents, they don't have houses like the one that we have today. So what they do is that, you see, things that they cherish is more. When they look left and right, back and front, and there's no one, their beads or let's say jewelry, they will wrap it and they dig a place. Like you see, palm tree can stay for many, many years, or this mango trees, if you don't cut it, is there for many, many years. So what they do is that they will point out one place, dig it, and keep their beads in there. So when something happens to them, and they die, then nowhere to be found their beads. Then when they are digging or they want to put up a building there or erosion is taking place, and they find a bead and they say bead from the ground. That's why in the Krobo language we call it zumwe. Zumwe. But all the beads are man-made. But these are some of the things that we don't tell people in outside world. If you come to Ghana here, even as at now, we don't have a museum. The one that we have in Accra, they are working on it more than 6 years now. They haven't finished it up to date, which is a big pity, but I don't know what to do. Things that we can learn,
yeah.
Or places where we can learn. Even here, we don't have anything like that. So I'm trying to, you know, in future, to make a bead museum. Because a lot of people heard about beads, they have been coming to Ghana, odumase-krobo, to know more about beads. And we don't have anything so much to show. So I'm working on it, it will take some time, but one day, I'll get there.
Yenkassa t-shirt.
Wow, that is great.
For Mr. Cedi.
Wow, I love it so much.
Until the lion learns how to tell its story, the hunter will always be the victim. So
that is great. Thank you so much for your gift.
And then
I love it so much.
It says Yenkassa, come for the story, stay for the knowledge.
That is good.
So, it speaks to what you've been.
Yes.
You just told us this afternoon.
Yeah. So, that is great. I love you so much.
Yeah.
You know, if we have people like 10 people like you in the country, this country will shine.
Thank you.
Yeah, we love to have people like you so that, you know, people will hear what you are doing and even Ghana also will grow.
Right.
Yes. Because we have good people, but the problem is how to, you know, move out,
right.
How to, you
right.
know, to sell ourselves.
Yeah.
So thank you so much. I love it. And
you're welcome.
I went with a special, you know.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Special pride.
Occasion and pride.
Yeah.
I'll make a matching bead also, like the one that you wear is really
yeah.
And I love the color also as well.
Awesome.
You know, I told you that ethnic colors.
Yeah.
Colors that are not too, you know, bright, but it's tough for itself.
Exactly.